Like the deer that yearns for running streams, so my soul longs for you, my Lord. Psalm 42, verse 1.
We have been proclaiming the good news for the past 1 year on Living Streams of Water.
We have never relented in our quest to win souls for Christ in this journey.
For the past 1 year, the journey has never been easy.
To our dedicated priests who always make time to come to the studio to share the word of God with us, and to those who supported, donated, advised, and guided us.
To our family and friends, thank you for your constant advice and support.
Baraka.
The buyer.
Asam.
Yedafi.
Tepuhoya.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. The angel of the Lord declared unto Mary, and she conceived of the Holy Spirit, Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and the hour of our death. Amen. Behold the handmaid of the Lord. Be done unto me according to your word. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and the hour of our death. Amen. And the word was made flesh, and it dwelt among us. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and the hour of our death. Amen. Pray for us, O Holy Mother of God, that we may be made worthy of the promises of Christ. Together we pray. Pour forth, we beseech thee, O Lord, your grace into our hearts, that we, to whom the incarnation of Christ your Son was made known by the message of an angel, may by his passion and cross be brought to the glory of his resurrection, through the same Christ our Lord. Amen. My dear brothers and sisters, you are welcome to Living Streams of Water. Today is Saturday of the 25th week in Ordinary Time. Would like to reflect with you with the first reading from the Wisdom Writer. Rejoice, O young man, in your youth, and let your heart cheer you in the days of your youth. Walk in the ways of your heart and the sight of your ears. But know that all these things God will bring you into judgment. Remove vexation from your mind and put away pain from your body. For youth and drone of life are vanity. Remember also your Creator in the days of your youth, before the evil days come, and the years draw near, when you will say, I have no pleasure in them, before the sun and the light and the moon and the stars are darkened and the clouds return after the rain, in the day when the keepers of the house tremble and the strong men are bent and the greatest cease because they are few and those that look through the window are dimmed, and the doors on the street are shut. When the sound of the gridding is low, and the one rising up at the voice of a bird, and all the daughters of Sang are brought low, they are afraid also of what is high, and terror are in the howl. The almond tree blossoms, the grasshopper drags itself along the desired field, because man goes to his eternal home, and the mourners go about the street before the silver cord is snapped, or the golden bowl is broken, or the pitcher is broken at the fountain, or the wheel broken at the cistern, and the dust returns to the earth as it was, and the spirit returns to God who gave it. Vanity of vanities, says the preacher, all is vanity. The word of the Lord. My dear friends in Christ, my few years as a priest have taught me something that I want to share with you today, especially for the youth. Why do I say that? All along, for about 6 years now, I've been in youth ministry. And sometimes parents will bring their children, "Oh, talk to my daughter. My daughter is stubborn. My daughter is doing this. My daughter is doing that." Each time I approach to speak about anything, many will quote this particular passage for me, that, "Father, even the Bible says that when we are youth, we should rejoice and do things. My father have done all these, and he doesn't want me to also enjoy. That is why he is saying that I should do this and this and that." So I will gladly listen. Then, when he has finished, I will say, "My brother, my sister, what you have said is true. But the issue here is that you have only taken one aspect of what the wise man said, and you have left the second part of it. As a youth, we have energy to do anything. I mean, we can do everything because we have so much energy in us. Is it the dressing? Is it the dancing? Is it the haircut? Is it what? That shows our identity, and it makes us really good, and we feel very happy about it. But my dear, there is something that is the second part of it which you have forgotten. And the second part, the Lord says that, the wise man, he says, remember also your Creator in the days of your youth, before the evil days come and your years draw near, when you will say, 'I have no pleasure in them.'" The first aspect, it is okay. He says, "Where should you rejoice, oh young man," let me even add young lady, "in our youth, and let our heart cheer in the day of our youth. We should walk in the ways of our hearts and the sight of our eyes." That is true. Is it the polishing we will do? Is it the small things, my friend? I am aware we will do. What is it? So you realize that those who drink will drink more. Those who are into other immoral acts will do more. Those who are in other things will do more. That is okay. But what about the second aspect of it? He says, "Remember also your God in the day of your youth." My dear brother, my dear sister, it is true that now there are many things that are going on, and technology have shown us many things as youth. But let us know that it is not everything that is also good in the sight of God. As we are young, we may do all things to make us happy. Is it the food? We will buy as much as we need to eat all the sausages and other things. But when we grow old, that is where we suffer from all kinds of diseases. So as youth, let us admonish ourselves this day and know that it is true that we are youth. It is true that we have energy. Let us do everything when we know that we also respect what the Lord is telling us to do. And what are these?
We should love our Lord God with all our heart, with all our soul, and with all our mind. And I believe that some of this admonition should begin in the house. My dear parents, the youth will go wayward because at the beginning of their life, when they were very young, at the age of even 1 to the age of 18, when have you called them together to pray in the house? When have you taught them the basic catechesis that they need to have? For example, the prayer of Our Father. For example, some petty things, Hail Holy Queen, Hail Mary, and other things. We often push them, go to the catechesis and go and learn. Go to the catechesis and go and learn. But we have also forgotten that our children are with us in the house 24 hours a day. They sleep with us. They eat in the house. They do all this. In Deuteronomy chapter 6, God told the people of Israel, and its title is called Shama Yahweh. He said, Shama El Israel, Elo Ila Elohim, Elo Eliham. He says, Hear, O Israel, your God is one, and you shall love the Lord your God with all your heart, with all your soul, and with all your mind. And you shall teach your children when they are sleeping, when they are eating, when they are working, when they are doing everything. My dear brother, my dear sister, this is the training that an Israelite, a Jew, gives to his child. What about you, a Ghanaian, a Dagao, a Frafra, an Ebe, a Ga? What training are you also giving to your own son, your own daughter, so that when he or she is growing, they wouldn't depart from it? There are some families that early in the morning they come together and pray. When they are going to sleep, a mom or dad is around, they say, Mommy, come and let us pray. Daddy, come and let us pray. Even if after the prayer you want to say good night to your children, that is good. But don't say go and pray whilst daddy and mommy are outside discussing things. No, they need to learn from you, dear parents. We need to get a grounding for ourselves so that each time we may seek you, we may seek God, and we may profess the right thing that we need to do. There are some families today that they do not mind. What they say is that when their child is going, you realize that he will pick one dress and put in a bag and wear another one. Why would a child do that if you have taught him or her modesty in the house, modesty in dressing, modesty in eating, modesty in everything? We need to change our ways, and our youth will also change. My dear youth, yes, we are youth. In as much as we rejoice, in as much as we want to do all other things, but also remember that we need to live according to the teachings of Christ. Let us resolve this day. And let us ask God to transform our hearts and mind and govern us in everything that we do. May God bless and keep you. May His face shed its light upon you and grant you His peace. May He bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Have a blessed day.
Like the deer that yearns for running streams, so my soul longs for you, my Lord. Psalm 42, verse 1.
We have been proclaiming the good news for the past 1 year on Living Streams of Water.
We have never relented in our quest to win souls for Christ in this journey.
For the past 1 year, the journey has never been easy.
To our dedicated priests who always make time to come to the studio to share the word of God with us, and to those who supported, donated, advised, and guided us.
To our family and friends, thank you for your constant advice and support.
Baraka.
The buyer.
Asante.
Yeah, that's it.
Simple, yeah.